Hi everyone, in this video I want to show you the Envato Elements plugin, how to use it for WordPress. The Envato Elements plugin can be used for free, and I will use the free version on this video. And in combination, you can also use the Elementor. The Elementor is also a really good plugin as a drag and drop to build up WordPress websites. Once we are here on your WordPress websites, you can easily go to the Add New and then search for Envato Elements. We just install both. And we activate them. Once we have both plugins activated, we will have here both Envato Elements and Elementor. And we can easily go here and start check out the free templates. The probably main advantage and one reason that I really recommend Envato Elements, and it's for people who are using WordPress and are building up WordPress websites, because it's easier to import these templates in comparison to importing them directly from ThemeForest, that sometimes you had to import direct the demo, and sometimes the demo doesn't look actually the same as in ThemeForest. And here on Envato Elements, it's easier, the import of the different kits that they have. And it's a matter of just searching and finding the best solution that you can have. The free templates are already really good, but in case that you want some more options or to import some even images, you can also get the Envato Elements subscription. As well with the Elementor, there will be some pages that you might be required to have the Elementor Pro, so in order that you can have more features. But in both cases, and if you're searching also for free options or alternatives, it can also be helpful for that. So you can import both ways, from here or from the direct page. That's what I'm going to do now. Jonas just gonna create a new page directly from Elementor. And as you see here, you will have the Envato Elements widget so that you can actually do the import from here. We go to free kits. These are the same that we were already seeing before. I'm gonna test out with this one and install the kit. As you can see, there will be some of the templates that will require or ask for some other plugins. If you already have the Envato Elements subscriptions, sometimes they will ask from those ones. Or, for example, in this case, it's asking for Elementor Pro. I will just deactivate these ones. And in terms of color schemes and typography, it will ask as well to do the installation. And as you can see here, there will be some pages that are asking here or are for the Pro. So you can be choosing the ones that are free and selecting the one that it's required for you. Here I will just insert the template. And the first time we will see that they're still here, the main state, Elementor and WordPress header. So to do that change, and if you want to avoid this, you just have to simply go here on settings. We will have to change the page layout. If you already have a predefined header with Elementor Pro, then you will just have to change for the full width, and you will have the header. But as well, if you want To remove this part, you just select Elementor Canvas. And now we don't have an, a specific header. Neither a footer. So a workaround for this is to create another section on Elementor. Can be different columns. And also here, we cannot add the menu directly. It's also for the Pro version. So what's a workaround for here? We can either create a text and I will just add menu and I will select, and this will be the, or I will change it to home page. This will be my home. And also let's say I want to add here kind of the logo. So I go back here, up here, just search for an image. I will select one from the media library. And I will just have to adjust the size. Let's say 200 and 100. If we want to set it here to the left side, more to the left, we just adjust the column width. And of course, as well, if we want more in the middle, we'll have to set out a vertical alignment here. So this is a tip of a workaround of not having an Elementor Pro possibility to add the header. As well, we just changed the background to a black one. And let's say here it's different color. We can just either adjust here. But since it's the link, it's not will be directly changed. So we will have to go here to select. Then we toggle to have more options and change the color. And we have it here. And if we want to underline, we just have it as well. This will be mainly on the default settings of the main theme. Now we publish. And if we want to set this as the main homepage, we will just go to Appearance, Customize, and do the normal WordPress workout so that here in the static page, in the homepage settings, we just change to the homepage. And we just publish. And we can just visit out the site. So this is linking to the homepage. And you can start building out your WordPress website. You can be adding more pages. And it's for free. Both, this is the workaround for the, also for the footer. It can be also another workaround. Let's test out to create some other page to add it here. So let's create this about us. Save as draft. We go back again. As you can see here, there is no predefined header, so we'll have to do again the work for creating the header. What we can do is go here to the main page, and we can save this one as template. So let's say header we will have here. And let's change it back again to canvas. And we can just insert here. And we will have here the header. If the change, we have to set it again to Elementor Canvas. And then we can import another page. So we have here the About Me. And you have it there. Okay, since the only option to add more pages here and to have it on a horizontal line will be by adding the WordPress links here in a text editor, because if we add directly here the navigation menu, we will see it here vertical. And we will have to set out the changes on the WordPress theme so that it can be on a different color. So that's on a, well, it's not the pro version, so you have to do this. This is a workaround things. But I do recommend getting better the Elementor Pro. But in case that someone is looking for some other alternatives, about we can just create here and just create here the link to the page. We change again the color, but the thing is that you will have to be changing again the header in the other pages. So this might be recommended only for a very small website that it's really looking for free alternatives. Have a look. I'm just gonna change back the URL. Here. And view page. Now we have here the home. But as you can see here, there is no the link to the about page, so we'll have to go back here to the Elementor about, have to underline and create the link. Now and we change the color, so that will be really too much work to do. But if we go back here to preview changes, now we have both. And there will be minor details that if it's not really all the copy paste of the both, but that's another way to use a free alternative that you can use here. That's why I recommend to get the pro version of Elementor. It's really easy. But in case that you want only to use free alternatives, Envato Elements recommended, Elementor highly recommended, but both the subscribed version and the paid version of Elementor are really good options. So I hope that this video helped you. If you have some questions, some more comments, don't hesitate to write down. Thanks for watching.